you all so much. Welcome, everyone, to the Extreme Dinosaurs Game Show. My name is Brian. I will be your host for the afternoon. I want to hear, make some noise if you feel you know a lot about dinosaurs. Make some noise if you feel you don't know very much about dinosaurs. Make some noise if you like making noise. Awesome. During our show today, we are going to be competing with two teams. We have our herbivores. We have our carnivores. Herbivores, from here over, you are my herbivores. You are big. You are massive. From this side over here, we have our carnivores. Very nice. Very loud. Through each of the questions, we are going to award millions of years. As those millions of years accumulate, you will move closer and closer to the end of the Cretaceous. The first team to become extinct wins. Awesome. Now we know because of our special taping today, we have a few randomly selected audience members who are wearing those special yellow tags there. We need some folks to come up and represent. Would you like to represent and help us out? Please give a big round of applause. What is your name?
Brian.
Brian. That is a...
Brian.
Oh, Ryan. I'm sorry, Ryan. You know what? You are almost the same as me because I am Brian. So you are Ryan? Brian. Now, Ryan, let me ask you. Would you like to be behind the podium or would you like to be working the scoreboard? Working the scoreboard, awesome. I like a lot of math going on there, too. Somewhere down here, someone has hidden the pieces we need for the scoreboard. There we go. Ryan, just like on the front there, we have a carnivore. We have a herbivore. Stick them on the Velcro there. As things go on, Ryan will be our master of mathematics. Right now, though, our first question is going over here to the herbivores. Herbivores, are you ready? Herbivores are standing by. Herbivores, we are looking in four potential categories. Our categories are finding food, staying safe, having offspring, or keeping warm. Anyone willing to call out from the herbivores? What would your first category be? Call out.
Hey.
Hey. All right, of these four choices, the choice is hey, which I think is going to be finding food. Finding food. Question number one. Tyrannosaurus Rex had knife-shaped teeth and sharp claws. This suggests... Oh, and I should let you know, Ryan, this is going to be worth 15 million years, if we get it correct. Knife-shaped teeth, sharp claws. This suggests Tyrannosaurus Rex, A, ate mostly meat. B, ate mostly plants. C, ate mostly people. All right, herbivores, let's hear it. What do you think, A, B, or C? A is absolutely correct for 15 million points moving forward. Oh, my goodness, the getting food team's going well. Carnivores, are you ready for your question? All right, herbivores going one. Oh, you can go three of those. It's 15 to two, three. Awesome, nice job, Brian. All right, let me get back to our main categories here. Over here on the carnivore side, which of these categories would you like? Sting, I see a little... We're staying with A. We're going to go through all of the A questions. Fair enough. Getting food, question number two. Paracerolophus fed on tough ferns and conifers, tree branches. In order to make its food into a digestible pulp, paleontologists think the Paracerolophus would A, mash the food under its huge feet, B, grind the food with its hundreds of tiny teeth, or C, saute the food with onions and garlic. A, B, or C, they say? B is absolutely correct for 15 million more points. Oh my goodness, we've tied it up. It's crazy. All right. You heard C over here. The herbivores are turning on us. It's terrible. All right, we're coming up here, and you know what? It is time for our first bonus round. We are going to play a little game called What's My Adaptation, and I need four volunteers. Four of these folks here with the little yellow tags. Where are my yellow tag folks? There is one. Would you come on up here and help? There is two. Come on over here. How about you in the blue shirt there? Oh, and in the white. Come on over. We've got one, two, three, and four. Welcome up onto the stage here, gang. Can you form a little row standing next to me? We'll go over this way. And let's meet our competitors. What is your name? Hi, Mia. Your name?
Remy.
Nice to meet you, Brammy.
Your name?
Natey.
Natey, nice to meet you. And what is your name? Joe. All right, gang. You guys are going to represent dinosaurs. We're going to give you some of the adaptations, some of the weird features that you'll find on some dinosaurs. Now, come on over this way a little bit. We'll get you to stand right there. Get you to stand right there. Get you to stand there. And get you to stand right over here. That's perfect. A nice little low row for me. All right. Some dinosaurs had a big horn in their head they could use to make sound. Can you represent our horn dinosaur? Awesome. Oh, don't eat it. Some dinosaurs had a big, long, clubby tail. They would swing around. Could you be our clubby tail dinosaur?
No. That's not gonna...
You would like to be our clubby tail dinosaur. That's perfect. All right, let me put that around there. I'll tie a little belt for you there. All right, big, clubby tail. Some dinosaurs had feathers to help keep them warm. Can I give you some feathers?
Ah, drop things on the floor.
Do you like some feathers? You don't want the feathers. Oh, I'll warn you, the last thing coming up is pretty weird. No, you're going for, all right, we're going to pass the feathers on over here. Feathers for you. Feathers for, oh, here, feathers for me. And I'm also, Ryan, you are the best helper I've ever had here. This is great. All right, the final thing. Some dinosaurs had a big bony ridge around their neck to protect them from predators. A big bony ridge. Huh? This is our big bony ridge. Can you hang on to that? You don't have to put it on your head if you don't want, but could you? You don't want to hold on to it? Can I put it in front of you? That's okay. Don't worry, you don't have to stand on it. You don't have to sit on it. We will not even acknowledge it. We'll pretend it's not even there. All right, now here's a challenge. And Ryan, you may not realize, you are actually going to be playing a role here. Ryan, I want you to look out at these herbivores. Look out at these carnivores. I want you to decide who you want to represent. This could be worth 50 million. Could be worth 10 spaces moving forward. I want you guys to woo Ryan over here. Herbivores, do you want him to play for your side? Carnivores, do you want him to play for your side? Oh, Ryan, it's up to you. Which side would you like to play for? Oh. Don't be intimidated. They're going to be weird either way. Herbivores, awesome! Ryan, come on forward here. All right, Ryan, we've shown you these four adaptations. I have here four dinosaurs. Triceratops, Confuciusornis, Parasaurolophus, and Diplodocus. Each of these has one of those adaptations. You are going to be past one of these things, and this is Ryan's choice. Ryan, you are... Oh, my goodness. We're in entirely the long round. Never mind. La-la-la, la-la-la-la-la, la-la-la, la-la-la, la-la-la. Ryan has 45 seconds to match the right dinosaur to the right adaptation. You can assist if you want to call out suggestions to him. Remember, we have the clubby tail, we have the feathers, we have the toilet seat bony ridge, we have the horn on the head. Are you guys ready? He's going to pass you one of these cards starting now. Here we go, 45 seconds. All right, we're passing it out. Hold it up there. Hold up which one you think he's got there. You got Confuciusornis, got Parasaurolophus. Oh my goodness, in 4 seconds, he is 100% correct. Big round of applause. And that's 10 forward. Over there. I would like to take these back from you. Can I take those cards there? I can take this little card here. That's awesome. Take this here. Can I take those feathers back from you? I'll take that little picture there. And can I take that tail away from you? There we go. And can we have a big round of applause for these amazing adaptation kids? Thanks, guys. You can grab your seats. Hello. You've decided to stay. That's all right. Hello. Don't worry. You're just going through a stage.
Can I get a high five? Awesome. Enjoy the rest of the show. Grab your seat there. Let me put this back.
You're really not going.
That's okay. You know what? That can be fun. Stick around. You and me. Hey.
Or hello. Hello.
Cool. All right. Now, I know you carnivores.
You were a little upset with that. You said we want a chance to win 10 million points as well. 10 million or 10 spaces up on the board there. Is this true?
Yeah.
You want a chance to redeem yourself?
Yeah.
Then we are going to play another little grand game here. This game is called... 100% correct. This game is called... Dino or No Dino. People ask me about the weird names you see for dinosaurs. Some of them come from where the dinosaur was found. Some come from a Greek description of the dinosaur. Some might be named after the person who found it. I'm going to show you the name of a dinosaur. I will give you a description. Now you tell me if you think this is a real dinosaur, actually exists and has been named by paleontologists around the world, or if it's no dino, it's something I just made up to be ridiculous. Dino or no dino? Are you ready, carnivores? Ryan, one step forward for each one they get correct here. Bambiraptor. Now wait for the description. Bambiraptor is 75 million year old bird-like dinosaur that is less than 1 meter long. Dino or no dino? No dino is the consensus, and dino. It is a real dinosaur, discovered in 1993 by a 14-year-old fossil hunter named Wes Linster. Cosmoceratops. Wait for it. We're building. Cosmoceratops. Wait. This is a hint for you. It's the world's horniest dinosaur. It has two massive horns and 13 bizarre decorative horns around its head. Dino or no dino? It is a dino. In fact, you can see it up in the Extreme Dinosaurs Gallery. All right, let's get a few more. Cheezosaurus. Although sharp and nippy, this old dinosaur's lack of a cottage made him blue. Eventually, he became fed up with the whole thing, and later evidence suggests he was ricotta up with a bad gang and clearly up to no gouda. Dino or no dino? No dino, that's right. Another 5-4 there, Ryan. Amargosaurus. Long spines down its neck and back measuring 20 inches long. Paleontologists speculated skin may have grown between these spines to help warm its blood. Dino or no dino? Dino. All right. Thesaurus. Wait. No. I want to read this one. It took me a long time to write. This dinosaur is prolific, abundant, copious, teeming, and plentiful, despite being ancient, prehistoric, primeval, antediluvian, and very old. Goes by many names and likes having people look up to it. Dino or no dino?
No dino.
No dino. They got that right. All right, getting close. Justin Biebersaurus. Wait. Maybe this will make it clear as we read. Only one set of specimens of this rare species has ever been found, consisting of 3 juveniles. Paleontologists examining the discovery concluded, baby, 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 oh. No dino! Moving forward there, Ryan. Oh my goodness. We're getting close here. Dracorex hogswartzia? Dracorex hogswartzia dinosaur bears a close resemblance to a fairy tale dragon with a bony head covered in spikes and knobs. Dino or no dino? Dino. Very surprising, but actually it was discovered by amateur dinosaur hunters in 2004. It was donated to the Children's Museum of Indianapolis, and they actually allowed all of the visitors, the kids who came to the Children's Museum, to name it. And there is an official dinosaur listed in the registers, Dracorex hogswartzia. You've been reading the card as I've been standing here. Brontosaurus. An enormous plant-eating dinosaur, the Brontosaurus walks on 4 legs and balances its long neck with a very long tail. Dino or no dino? Yes, this will be kind of split there. No dino. Surprisingly. It is no dino. And you know what? I don't know what they're called. I'm gonna give it to them. I think we got close enough on there. In 1879, someone dug up what they thought was a brand new species. They discovered later that it was actually one they already knew about, the Apatosaurus. They just gave it the wrong head. So Brontosaurus, although it was sticking around for many years, doesn't actually exist. It is not a distinct species. Awesome. Lovely job there. Give yourselves a big round of applause for the dino no dino round. We are back over to our herbivores to pick the next category. We have only a few moments left. Herbivores having offspring in a very tasteful way. We will have some offspring. All right, we are going to go for question number two. Ah! That's not the question we want. Go back. Question number two. Ah. Pachycephalosaurus had a huge bony dome on the top of its skull that was 23 centimeters thick. Paleontologists think the Pachycephalosaurus used this thick skull to attract a mate by A, bashing heads with other Pachycephalosauruses like battling muskoxen. B, headbutting other Pachycephalosauruses in the side to establish dominance. Or C, creating a 23 centimeter thick comb over to hide their bald spot. Over to you, herbivores. A, B, or C? All right, let me hear it. A lot of votes for A. A chance to steal over here, carnivores. They say B. B is absolutely correct. That's, actually, we're back to another 15, so they're moving forward. 3, 1, 2, 3. Oh, my goodness. It's close. You guys said A, and sadly, A was not correct. All right, back over to the carnivores. You are trailing by 5 million. This next one is worth 120 million years. Surprisingly, it could take you right up to extinction. What category would you like? No, of these four categories. Getting food, staying safe, having offspring, staying warm. Staying safe. Staying safe. That's got to find it, yes. All right, and actually, you know what, Ryan? We got four staying safe questions. Is there one that you like there? He's going to look through here, going to find a hard one here. This one. I like your thinking. All right, carnivores, for 120 million years, possibly taking us off the end of the board. Yes. Staying safe. Gigantoraptor is the largest toothless dinosaur that has yet been discovered. Not having teeth, what do paleontologists think it may have used to defend itself? A, its ability to fly. B, its heavily armored body. Or C, its powerful snapping beak. A, B, or C? It's a tricky question. All right, we're consulting here. All right, carnivores, we need your answer. What's it going to be? C is correct, taking you off the edge of the board. Oh, my goodness, take them all the way down past the 70 million there. Oh, herbivores, you look upset. No. You know what? We can settle this. Ryan, are you willing or to help out one more time? All right, I'm going to give you this. Ryan, I'm going to ask you to step forward. Now, please do not help Ryan in any way. Ryan, I'm going to show you our final round. Our final round is the ultimate bonus round, the Paleo Spelling Bee. I'm going to give you some words associated with paleontology to spell. One for each side. These words can earn points for either side. All right, Ryan, looking forward? Now, for 125 million points for the herbivores, bringing them up to a tie, this is the word I would like you to spell, Ryan. Egg.
E-G-G.
Is correct for 125 million. Bring it up to a tie. All right, but in fairness, we do want you to get a word to spell for the carnivores, too. So for the carnivores, this could put you ahead, or we could still end in a tie. Is that okay? All right, Ryan, move forward. Final word for the carnivores. Can you please spell Pachycephalosaurus? No. He gives up. It's going to end in a tie. Give Ryan a big round of applause for helping us out here. That is awesome. Ryan, grab your seat. That was fantastic scorekeeping. I want to thank all of you for coming out here to the Extreme Dinosaurs Game Show. If you have any questions about dinosaurs, about anything at Science World, come and see me. Can I hear one more big cheer? And enjoy the rest of Science World. Thank you very much.